Road Dogs Music.
That's what I was doing. Hey, in New York, you either robbing niggas or you selling drugs, one or the other. Okay? There's no fucking medium. And if you add up all the time spent on the block trying to sell that shit, you working for fucking minimum wage. Might as well go to McDonald's. I ain't doing that. I let the motherfuckers make that money. Follow them to wherever they go to stash they shit. Get them. Quick money. It's like, yo, we see you back out here, we gonna get you. And I'm like, yeah, alright, whatever. You gonna get this in your head. They came and got me, man. I don't wanna sit here like I'm a tough guy like that. You know what I'm saying? I gotta handle mine, I will. And that's not a problem. I'm gonna start trouble with people, I don't do that shit no more. You know what I'm saying? But them motherfuckers really got me. And I took it light, like my father, man. It was serious. And they got me. I got to the hospital, the doctor's like, yo, how the fuck are you still alive, kid? You know how much blood you lost? It wasn't my time to go.
When you go out and, like, do you think there's, like, a magnet of attention that follows him? Like,
it's easy to say. That's my boy Tattoo, man.
Fucking yeah. Right. This motherfucking like, OG Rose, like phone Road like, Dogs. Man. When this nigga walks in the place, everybody goes, Road Dogs.
Road Dogs right here. Yeah. Fan bound for life, homie. Right?
Yes, sir.
If you don't like it, fuck yeah.
Fuck you. Right. But it's mutual respect with everybody in the industry because it's a small circle. You know what I'm saying? And everybody knows each other. We jump around, we help each other, and that's how we all advance. You know what I'm saying? I was blessed to do a TV series with him, The Nest.
Yeah, The Nest.
On the scene with the Aztecs right here.
Damn right.
Classic, y'all. So we making history right now, so be on the lookout. Y'all haven't seen nothing yet.
Yeah, Tattoo, Paper Rock, Flip Mode. Shout out to the General Buster. Shout out to my big brother, Split Star. Shout out to Road Dogs Entertainment, too. They out here kicking it with us, getting it in with the movie shit. You know how we do it. It's all natural professionals right here, baby. We knocking out scenes one shot.
Mr. OG Rome, Mr. Everywhere, man. Road Dogg Entertainment in the place to be. Live in effect, straight and direct in your motherfucking mouth, bitch. From there, you know, we got to know each other and building our friendship and relationship and helping each other out, man. He's like you said earlier, you can't judge a book by its cover.
Yeah.
He's actually a real humble, good person. And but it's true what he says. You can't take nobody's kindness for weakness because we come from the streets. Trying to become bosses and own our own things and be independent, but you gotta change your state of mind and act like a boss. You can't just be out there giving attention to the dumb motherfuckers who ain't done nothing and just trying to look at you and poke at you and talk about you, you know? You gotta stay humble and just keep pursuing your dreams.
Yeah, he's learning.
You know what I'm saying?
He just got his first haterism. I told him, welcome to celebrity life. One on camera right now, we gotta welcome
him. Hey, haters, don't watch me, watch TV.
Yeah, man, he's just trying to better his life. He's a fucking dude alone.
For the most part, everybody's supportive.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's a small circle, so if you ain't in that circle, you just upset because you're not doing what we're doing. But the key to success is fucking simple.
Yeah.
Hard work. Get up out your ass. If you work hard, it's gonna create avenues and doors, and then, like, money comes and goes.
But yeah, it does.
History will always be remembered, and everything you do will become history.
Love to me is like, when a person will be there for you unconditionally, with no strings attached. You know what I'm saying? Just because they were born based on respect and principle. Just cause, you know, not looking for a handout. Not looking just, I'm gonna do this for you so I can have something to hold over your head in the future. You know what I mean? That's fake love. Love is when a nigga's like, yo, you got beef, nigga? Let's go. I got you. And all my niggas do that for me.
Trust.
Okay? See around me, and I only let certain people around me. I don't hang with everybody, and they'll tell you.
Are you thinking you're an affectionate guy?
Oh yeah, I'm very affectionate. You know what I'm saying? I love puppies and shit and dogs. You know what I'm saying? I like to ride roller coasters and eat cotton candy and popcorn and shit. You know, when it comes to the kids, you know, I stop the ice cream truck, open up a tab, let them all come through. You know what I mean? Like, yeah.
Tattoo love the kids.
You know what I'm saying? Like, straight up, you know?
For real, man. Can't judge a book by its cover.
Exactly. And but coming along with that, too, you also have to stand a firm ground as well. You know, because a lot of people take that shit, like, for a kindness.
Right.
And I'm pretty sure you're like, you know, fucking be a man up is sort of like the mantra that your parents have told you.
Yeah.
Get smart and man up. And like, did you think that, did you look at yourself and think that you were ugly as a kid?
Not as a kid. I thought I was a handsome guy. My mom always told me I was handsome, so, you know, I believed it. You know what I mean? I don't give a fuck about anybody else. My mom said you're handsome kid, so I believed it. But it got to where, you know, when you have big fucking slice marks, like I look like Chucky when they sewed him up after he got fucked up. You look at yourself in the mirror like that, you know, you don't want to go outside looking like that. It gave me a complex. Like, people's gonna see that and think I'm soft, you know, I'm a fucking sucker. Like, you just run up on me and do that to me anytime. No motherfucker.
2015, Ripley's gonna bring me back out for being the most tattooed person in the world again. And Guinness is gonna put me in the book as well. They wanna, you know, spice up for the new year, have something, you know. It's been quiet for them. So, I'm trying to get everything done so I am the most tattooed person in the world again. Spots. I gotta work on my thighs and stuff, but we're almost done. We're about 98% Let Mo Swag, shout out to General Busta, shout out to my big brother Split Star, you know how it is. I'm also known as the Tattoo Godfather. I'm putting down for the tattoo work. I've been doing this for a long time, 95, 96. So I've been in the game for years. Trust me. Check me out on Instagram, Tattoo 7666. And my Facebook is my government, Chris Fonz. You can add me on that as well.